So then, ladies and gentlemen, I've had a few requests to do a how-to guide on modern houses. So, I'm going to do a build tutorial on this house behind me. I've featured it a couple of times on the channel, but I'm going to show you how to make your very own modern house. Let's jump straight into it. No more messing about. Right then, just before we start, I want to make you aware. I am going to be using the new glass wall set. I know not everybody has it yet, so you may just have to improvise when we get to that stage, until you do get it. Flamethrower traps are also a must in this build, so just thought I'd make you aware of that before we start. You want to have something like this as your first step. Four foundations with double walls there. There, there, then leave a gap of two foundations like that and plonk another set of double walls on the end there. If you don't know how to do double walls, I'll leave one of those floaty cards up in top corner. Just have a click on it and it'll take you to a guide I've done. It's dead easy, don't worry about it. The next step is to get some walls to sit there, like that. There is a way of doing it, and I'm going to show you. I find it easier to get rid of that there, so this foundation won't snap to anything. And all you want to do is you just want to drag it forward, like that. It may have a habit of rising up, just make sure it's level, like that. There you are. Now, that's only possible because these walls here are doorways. If these were solid walls, you wouldn't be able to freely move around this here, so just bear that in mind. And what we're aiming for is the end of this foundation to sit in the middle of the doorway pieces, or as close as possible. Don't have to be perfect. Let's see if we can get just a little bit better. I'm going to say roughly there, like that. Aye, that's not far off. That'll do job. And then you can get your wall piece and snap it in there. We also want to do that here, but it's easier this time round because we've already got it there. So you want to grab your foundation pieces, snap them in like that. Put your walls in. Sorted. You don't need put one there, don't worry. Beautiful. That's what you should be left with. You can then grab your foundations. Let's start at this side. Oh, she's being a bit of a bugger. Let's try here. Or here? Nope. What is going on then? There we are. And you can just drag them backwards like that to the original position. Simply, simply lovely. So that is step one completed. Let's move on to step two. Let's give you a quick last look at that. Right then, so this is the most difficult part of the build, but it's not overly complicated. We'll get it done, don't worry. We're going to start off up here, where this glass wall is. As you can see, I've made this little scaffold here. You do need to put it in, and it's for the flamethrower trap, so you can destroy certain walls, and it allows you to put a roof in up here. That's why we built this glass wall and top arch here. So if you just want to copy that, throw it into place. Doesn't matter where ladders are, doesn't matter where foundations are, as long as that floor is in the same location there, job's a good one. All sorted? Fantastic. Let's crack on. So, up here, we've put this in place, and it is literally just for the roof. I've got it set up so the roof will face out that way, rather than coming in this way. And what we're going to do is just snap this piece on top here. Can be a bit tricky to place, but there you go, it's on. And that's it for up here at the moment. Let's go back down to the bottom. What you want to do here is grab some full-size walls, snap them in place there. A half wall, snap that in place there. Wallpaper side facing outwards. And another full wall in top there, like that. Finally, grab yourself a top arch piece and place that there, like that. Dead simple. The top arch piece is the last piece that goes in. Put these in first, and then that piece, the top arch. If you don't do it that way, it can stop you from double walling here. Right, back up to the top we go, because we need to get these slanted glass pieces in here like that. And as you can see, it doesn't want to go in. We've got to find a way around that. So this is where we need our flamethrower trap. Let's just come round here. And we need to destroy this piece here, like that. So let's get that out at where. Beautiful. And as you can see, it's destroyed that top arch there. That's what we want. We'll just leave that destroyed for now. But we still have this in the way. The way I remedy this, because obviously it's quite high up, I get a couple of stash boxes, fall down to my death and break both of my legs at the same time. Right, I get two stash boxes like that. Put them on top of each other. Get the flamethrower trap and just place it on top like that. You can then grab your bottom stash box, spin it round, and spin it round a little bit more. And now we should be able to hit that doorway. Like that. Let's just trigger it. And then that's destroyed as well. Fantastic. What we want to do now is, wherever they are, put some double walls in here, like that. And this is literally just so you can wallpaper the interior of your house when you come round to it. Same on top there with a full-size wall. Put that in. Jobs are good. Now, we should be able to delete these here now. I could be wrong. Nope, it's let us do it. Fantastic. And we want to repair this top arch here. We don't want to repair these two pieces, just this top arch. And then we can get our glass walls, pop them in place, hit repair on these ones, like that. And we're in business. Look at that, you see. Right then, so this is the home straight now. Dead simple from here on out. We're going to start off with this tower area here. And we're going to start by, if it will let me, putting down a foundation. Need two foundations back to back to be able to double wall. That's why we're putting that there. Throw down two walls like that. Can then get rid of it. We'll then get a half wall and pop that in there. For this top window up here, I think these type of windows would look nice. So let's put that one in there. We'll just do the same here. Like so. This isn't going to be a window here though, so we don't need to put a brick one in. There we are, you see. It's coming together already. I'm going to do the same here and change these to the brick windows, like that. And then we need to go inside and start making the floor, because this is going to be a little balcony area. We may even be able to use this scaffolding to make our floors, so let's just try it. I am going to move the stairs over one though, like that. And that's just so we can access this area here. So I'll just get some floor pieces. Start putting these in, like that. And then this is where we're going to make our balcony. We may struggle because of the walls that I see. Won't let me snap it in place. The way to do that is I drag these pieces forward, like so, and then I delete them, like that. The reason I've dragged that forward is because I now have a reference point to put that wall back in, because obviously it's sitting at a bit of an odd angle. So I can now put the floor in. Can't snap it in there again, as you can see. But I can also drag this piece forward. Delete that. Put my floor in. Put my wall back in, like that. Job's a good one. And then we can drag these pieces back to where they should be. At least in theory, I should be allowed to drag them back. And that's because they're not a doorway. See? Has to be a doorway. The magic. Don't ask me why. Let's do the same with that there. Beautiful. And we can finish putting our floors in now. Alright. Now on this side, I tend to put glass walls in. If you don't have them, you have to substitute it for something. But a little tip as well, the full size ones, they have that metal bit along the bottom. It's not actually glass panes. However, the half ones are full glass. And in my opinion, they look a hell of a lot nicer. There you are, you see. And we can probably do the same along this back wall here. Maybe transition into, I don't know, contemporary set, there, like that. Ideally, you double wall them as well, so you can wallpaper the other side, but you're not going to see it at back. And then, again, should we put glass here just to match it up to the other side? Yeah, why not? Let's put them in there like that. Then we can finish our floor. Like so. Oh, that's going to annoy me. There we are. And that is pretty much the ground floor done. Starting to take shape now. You could even leave it like that, to be honest with you. Doesn't look too bad, but we're going to build up there. And we'll get on to that on the next bit. Right, guys, so we're back, and this is the final stage. Finishing off the frame itself. The decorating, we'll come to that, don't worry. I'm going to give you a quick walk around it because it's hard to see what's going on from the inside. I've already started building up on the second floor, and all I've done is replicated what I've done at the bottom. Dead simple. This whole back area is just one big square. There's nothing fancy about it. There you are, you see. And if you don't have the glass walls, you can replace them for anything you want, really. You know, it's just I use them because I've got them. And I do like them, actually. I urge anybody who's, you know, not quite finished the armour ace run, get on it, because it does open a world of possibilities for building. Right, let's go and have a look inside. So this balcony area here as well, before I finish off the, you know, the top floor, you can use conduits to make railings for balconies, you know, like around certain areas. I mean, you could even build bridges with conduits. You can do some really cool stuff with them. I am going to do a video on it at some point, but just bear that in mind when you're building. You can, you know, have a mess about with them, see what you come up with. Right. So all I've done here is I've put another set of stairs in. I've done it like that to try and save space. Literally just plunk floors in there. That doesn't need a video explanation, does it, guys? We can just throw them in there. It's dead easy. Then up here, I've made like a rooftop garden area. On my main character, I've got a little greenhouse here, but I don't have the farmable tiles on this tomb, so I can't do it on this one. But let's carry on anyway. Let's put this roof in. Start with that. Then we're going to get some half walls. Now, I can't double wall these here because I've not got any walls in at the bottom, but if you did put double walls in down there, you'd be able to have that effect as well. Over here, we're going to put a little slope on top there, like that, little top arch. Just going to replicate that over there. Get our roof piece, and it'll snap to the outside of it because of the way it's angled. You see? It's going to want to shoot off over there, but that's okay. Let's just get it in and fall. Fantastic. But when we get that initial roof piece in, let's get back up here. We should be able to snap another one to the side of it, like that. And then delete this first one. Beautiful. And get an half wall in there. And a little top arch in there. Sorted. Look at that, you see. And get some roofs in here. Like so. And a little half wall and top arch over here. And it's slowly starting to come together now. If it'll let me put it in there. Why are you being awkward? There we go. There we are, we're in. Let's get rid of that. And like I say, on my main character, this is my little greenhouse area here, so that's pretty much what I've got. Now, all around here, I'm going to put these down. And on the end here, we're going to put a top arch, like that. And again, same principle as up there. Oh no, we don't have to do that actually. Because it's already double walled, we can just do that. And it should just snap straight into place. This one's always a bit of a bugger though, for why not? There we go. Half walls in there. And that's it. Roof completed. Dead simple. Let's go and have a look from downstairs. Oh, that was a quick way down, wasn't it? And obviously areas like this, you know, you can come along and put walls in. You know, I mean, you can pretty much put them wherever you want, to be honest with you. The world is your oyster. And that is what you'll be left with. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to disappear, go around it, you know, put some wallpaper on it, tidy it up a little bit. Not sure if I'm going to decorate the interior because I have already shown this build twice now on the channel, so you can have a look at them videos for a bit of inspiration. Catch you in a second. And this is the finished product. A nice, simple, modern house. Exterior wise, I've used a stone wallpaper from the contemporary set. And the white wallpaper, I think, is from the solid colour wallpaper set, but I could be wrong, don't quote me on that. I've not done any interior design because I've featured this twice on my channel, as I've mentioned before, so I'll leave one of those floaty, hovery cards up in top corner. If you want to have a look, click on that, and it'll show you some of the interiors I've done in this camp in the past. Anyway, guys, I hope this build guide has been useful to you, and you can now build your own modern house. Thank you very much for watching, stay safe, and have some fun.